total misunderstandings of the marriage supper of the Lamb. That comes primarily from Isaiah 25, where there will be a mountain of food upon the latter day mountain, of which God would remove the veil that has covered all mankind and bring us spiritual freedom, removing our yoke of burden, as Jeremiah 31 straight out says. I dare you to read it. Because the world has been standing on a covenant that has never ever been given up until I first proclaimed it once, so that it would fulfill the scripture that all sin upon planet Earth has now been put away from God's sight, because he declares, I am your God, you are my people, I will and I have forgiven your iniquity, and if I did not, I would be a liar, says the Lord. And all who love are born of me and know me, because I am love, saith the Lord, 1 John 4:7. So in this hour, as his word came forth unto me, it was a blessing. And so I say unto all people who really want to no more see through a glass darkly, prophetically, so that we can have our eyes open to see that our Son of Love is arising as the Son of Love and righteousness over one and all of us, to destroy the shattering of the power of the holy people and them hogging heaven as if they were the only ones that he has called to. He promised that he would arise as the good shepherd over all the flocks of man. And that is exactly what he's doing in this day of him giving the covenant unto Israel, as Jeremiah 31 once said it would come in the latter days. And anything else is hogwash, because the God was smart, you know. His kingdom age new covenant foretold to tear down all kingdoms of man's imaginations. Jeremiah 1:10, Haggai 2:2 says the same thing. That covenant would only be given by the messenger of Malachi 3:1. Jesus Christ never said once the words of that covenant. He was not his own messenger. The messenger of Malachi 3:1 that prepares his way so that he's no longer kept in heaven and kept reserved, Acts 3:21 says, if his restoration of the understanding of his love does not happen, then this world would be doomed. But his word reopening had to happen, as Daniel 12:9 foretold. For when the message of Malachi 3:1 came forth to prepare his way, it was addressed to Israel and all mankind. For the Lord God has always said, I am the Lord God of all mankind. But identities were switched. Christianity became Israel, and they were not. And then they said that all the prophecy for Israel was not even for them, it was for them. And they stole the blessing, just as Jacob stole the blessing from Isaac, stole Esau's blessing. It was switched identities. And so they became Israel, and then Christians became all mankind. And they ignored what the word of God actually says, and they always have. So let us finally allow our love within and his love over us to shine as the brightest horizon, the nicest sunset of the rainbows of his yea and amen promises. I'm Daniel from the North, Isaiah 41 here for you. And I pray that somebody may someday grow a little bit of love, and even love, even though I've been considered as an enemy, that you might even find a little bit of room and compassion in your heart for an old guy who's trying to lift up our risen lamb-hearted lion and lion-hearted lamb that was slain before the foundation of the earth for all mankind. And so in these days, may all opening up their ears as well find and receive faith and mercy from our everlasting mercy of Jeremiah 30:24's rock-solid promise. God is declaring that he will end our fast-rising tribulation, just as he did not destroy Nineveh in Jonah 4, and the word says he relented. And the Lord says, and it shall be considered in the latter days through my messenger of Malachi 3:1, that I will return my fierce and terrifying anger if only my people will just be loving and kind and start even liking the videos of my messenger who has given the law of my love. That is an unbreakable law. And so he promises that he would tear down in this great tribulation the spiritual demonic battles of man's lovelessness, so it can be turned back finally at the gates of hell, from which such shallowness of understanding of love that comes from believing falsely that our God has conditional love for us, which he has never had. So receive now, because if that was true, then he could not say, I will forgive your iniquity and never remember it. It eliminates the judgment day, as most people have falsely imagined, because he has judged us with love. And that is the judgment of Zechariah 3, as he sends forth his flying scroll for the internet from his dove of love, as Zechariah 5 says. Yea, it is the everlasting gospel of Revelation 14, the sickle of his word. For he is the sower of the seed of love, who has overtaken his reaper, as Amos 9 prophecy fulfilled explains. So love from love, hope from hope, and peace from peace unto all mankind within these days of Elijah, which is introducing the name of Chrislam, which is just a new name for Israel that was predicted for them to be appointed in the latter days in Isaiah 62:2, and the word says so. And if this did not happen, God would be a liar. And as the word of love came forth unto me, the son of Hubert and Lois, and proud uncle of Bronson and Colton Tristan, the word of his most precious excellence then said, always forgiven are all those of love, willing to write kindness in marble and revenge in the dust. And as the Lord's most amazing kingdom age word of our Prince of Peace's love came forth unto me, the one predicted from the north in Isaiah 41, it held the uttermost energy of creation, the power of the Holy Spirit overflowing, and it held the mightiest might of kingdom age love that's ever been imagined by any theologian, and nor could anyone ever possibly deny that its overpowering presence of divine unconditional love was of love unconditionality alone. And that is what came forth when his living waters flooded over my soul so lovingly, so that his deepest love's most passionate glory was shining and blazing within me and upon me, as it came forth like a most glorious speed that was far beyond lightning's fastest strike or thunder's loudest roar. And so in these days, it's time to realize, as Mickey and Avi said, it's a time to realize that God's arms have never been too short to save. He just wants to embrace all who will embrace love divine. And it's time to realize, if there are any strings attached to our love, it's never been love at all. That is the gross darkness of our understanding of love. True love has no strings attached. Love is for no other reason than love loves to love. And my big kitty, he's reminded me that we must stay as a little child, like Mickey and Minnie says, because this has been a world of festering tears and fears far too long. And now I hear the roaring purr, the happiest purr of our roaring lion of Zion, that comes forth as if he was just a little itty bitty kitty. Can you hear his loving whispers? Because it will happen in this world, not by power nor by might, but only by his spirit of love, fulfillment of Amos 9. And so in this hour, it's time to get with his programs of love, and it's time to welcome love that has now made all religion upon earth totally obsolete, for the perfect has come, exactly as Hebrews 8 Paul predicted would happen in the latter days, that all faith prior to this faith of overflowing love would just blow away as the smoke. Just read it, Hebrews 8, because when you hear the words, I am your God, you are my people, that is when it would happen in the latter days. And so know very well that the conclusion of the perfect love, unconditional love, unveiled as the Lord puts his sickle of love into the earth to reap the earth for his harvest of love. And so it's time that we need to get with his understandings that have been the mystery of God, Revelation 10:7. And it came to pass that the first is last, and the last is first, and the seventh trumpet then sounded first in my hearing. And when it did, glory, hallelujah. And so I heard the voice of our beloved love of the ages speaking softly to my heart. And he then declared unto all mankind, and I clearly heard his voice resonating through the heavens, as even the sapphire sea on high received ripples in his living water with the blessedness of the sea of that forgetfulness and his forgiveness shining forth unto earth. And then he declared unto all people of love, moving forth as a little child, that one of us will become a thousand, and multiplicity will happen. So he says, let the rigor of our justice of love be softened by the chastisements that comes from the lack of mercy. But mercy shall you have, and that is what shall happen until his love is executed upon all mortals. So he says, let the attribute of our living mercy become now manifested, and let the creatures now be enriched, and let the word of patience come that has been sent forth in this world during COVID, the trial of all flesh of Revelation 3:10, that has come to bring God's word of patience to keep us from the hour of the temptation not to listen to the common sense that love is not even love if there's strings and manipulations attached. This should be apparent unto people with a brain. So it's time to embrace our treasure of grace, our excellence of treasure, our priceless pearl of great reward. For his eternal glory shall cover the earth as waters cover the sky, as grass cover the lands, as sands cover the most desolate of deserts. I am the latter-day Daniel, who is Elijah. I am the one whose eyes are red and dull of wine, because I got an ashtray here full of doobies. I smoke, and praise God I quit drinking, but it is written that the one who comes forth with eyes red, and they get red from weed, people, not from wine, the one whose eyes are red and dull of wine would hold the scepter of all authority, says Isaiah 49:8. And the only reason Moses named Shiloh, which was never Jesus, he wasn't an alcoholic with eyes red and dull of wine, come on, people, the only reason he wrote Shiloh was simply because the first Elijah had never yet come at that point. So understand now, and beware all snivelers out there grumbling and mumbling at me that I'm adding to the word of God. I keep talking about the sword becoming the sickle. In the Bible it says plowshare, but people, do a Bible Hub search of that word plowshare, and you're going to find a lot of translations all translated as sickle also, because Christ's sickle of Revelation 14 is what shall reap the earth. So I'm not making up anything. Randy Beast. Pharisee that keeps bugging me. And in this time, it's time to realize that blessed is the person of love who's opening up their lips in praise of his Lord God of Sabaoth, who praises the Lord with his deepest heart of hearts. And most blessed are all loving people, blessing the works of the Most High, including this channel. Ignoring the praise at this channel is sinful. It is antichrist. And all those not liking it are not liking to follow the ways of love at all. They are antichrist with their conditional love. So it's time that all the wheat must come with me. The great falling away is a command of God that in the latter days the wheat can now no longer grow with the tares. I am the bringer of the message for the wheat, and they shall all come with me, and the rest shall stay behind, as all religion on earth falls like a house of cards, exactly as Jeremiah 1:10 and Haggai 2:2 foretold in the latter days, that all kingdoms of man's imaginations, loveless ones, would come on tumbling down when the true message of his unconditional love finally came forth, as prophecy has so clearly foretold. And so in this hour, it's time to embrace these words here at this channel as being some of his strongest light, and the lighthouse of his love needs to be shined. The everlasting gospel needs to go again to all people, to all tribes, and people ignoring this channel, not liking it, you are impeding and stopping your own Lord from returning unto earth, exactly as Acts 3:21 predicts, if the restoration of all things through this latter-day Daniel who comes to restore all things is not obeyed. I am to be obeyed. I am the lawgiver of love. There's no difference between Moses and I, except I was born to be Shiloh. I was born to be Joshua of Zechariah 3. I was born to be the name Israel for a man in Isaiah. It's all the same guy, the latter day Daniel, who must try to turn the hearts of the fathers to the children and children to the fathers, so this earth won't be totally messed up and totally destroyed, as Malachi 4:6 says. But praise God that unless God's word did reopen, as Daniel 12:9 clearly says, because it was only open, closed till the time of the end, when the Lord's message of Malachi 3:1 had to come forth to prepare his own way of love. And so in this hour, blessed are those hearing me, but accursed is everyone daring to open their lips in order to bring forth evil animosity and finger pointing towards this channel from their neighbors over this message of love. For such backward souls have much contempt for God. Therefore, such fools would naturally despise any work of holiness like this that lifts up his most lofty names of love. For Jehovah Nissi is the banner of love over one and all of us. And greatly accursed are all those bringing the race of Adam ironic contempt concerning his very best good news of love. And woe to them who are condemning his praise here at this channel. So beware, O whiners, who shall foolishly criticize the scripture, proclaiming line by line, precept by precept, it was not good enough, that Isaiah 28 must return void unto the Lord because people despise the truth. The truth that his love covers a world of our evils. Jesus said that all of our blasphemies, even blasphemy against him, would be forgiven. Only the unforgivable sin of letting the light of love within us go right out, that is the unforgivable sin, because he is love living within us. John the Beloved declares that in 1 John 4:7. And so in this hour, it's time for everyone to finally, eventually see that our living truth is well reflected within his prophesied charity. And he is now speaking anew to this Joshua generation who may go in and inherit the promises, if only they will believe that the word of God has predicted that we have had nothing but desolate heritages because we've been looking through a veil darkly and we have not seen his unconditional love over us clearly at all. And so in addition, the anointed word of new hopes will come forth now. And because I've done a lot of research, and through the Lord's inspiration of love moving herein, such intensity as the world has never heard, someone passionate like me emotionally, day after day, bringing forth a word of hope for a hopeless generation. And the Lord long ago sent these promises that all things would be restored and that it had to happen before Christ returned. I'm the very best candidate for that end time, Elijah, because I am Daniel. That is my name. Isaiah predicted it. Joshua predicted it. Zechariah predicted it. The Lord predicted it. And so people need to let their passionate, fervent voices of love now ring out harmoniously about this great Kingdom Age channel where the passion of Christ is flowing. Tell your neighbors about this channel. Share these videos. Please like and subscribe. And if you don't, you're standing against God's love in action and revealing yourself as just someone loveless, no divine love. It's not even moving anymore because you've become just standing in the land of the walking dead, only having a form of love and denying the power thereof by letting it die. And so it's time to let our Lord God also receive our prayers and know as well that the most loving charity of our giver of benevolence has always been kind, meek, patient, without emulation, without envy, and such is without any form of offensiveness. For his flowing unconditional love never has desired to acquire anything from us aside from the loving loyalty of all those who claim to love him, and more than ever in the process, such righteous souls twisted in their hearts and imagination. In order to be free of that, they need to begin exalting every work under the sun that gives their Lord God of love a big thumbs up, to promote the kind of glory that is not hazy as people have looked before, because a clear picture of his love ablaze now comes with the kind of love that the Lord continually, righteously, rightfully deserves. And that's the level of love that we need to be sending towards him in appreciation for all that he has done. For I tell you truly, all things have worked together for good for those who are called according to his purposes of love. And all of us, every single one, has been. And so in this hour, praise him evermore, for he is our abundant love, the one filling our heaven of heavens with his most abundant light that can never end. Let us shine, let us shine, let us shine. Let the world arise and shine, for your truest light has now come.